Trent Bradshaw, Brandon Rogers, Bradshaw Financial Planning, and Mind Your Money. Thank you for joining us for this market update, March 22nd, 2021. Agenda today, we're going to touch on global equity flows in regards to how much money has been going into stocks. Secondly, we're going to talk about the reflation trade and some of those sectors that have been pretty much on fire here today. And then third, we'll talk about reallocations, which are coming up in the next week and a half. All right, before we jump in, let's talk about a few things in regards to the Federal Reserve. The Federal Reserve, obviously, and Congress approved the stimulus plan that will be distributing $1,400 checks to approximately 100 million people in the U.S. And there's estimates that potentially could drive 100 to 150 billion of that into the market. So that could be a tailwind to the market going forward. Mm-hmm. But evidence of that, let's take a look at this first chart. The first chart is looking at global equity flows, meaning how much money has been drawn into the markets around the world. And what you'll see in the last year, it's about $1.7 trillion. It's a massive number compared to all the subsequent years that you see on this chart. From 2002 to where we are today, even some of those good years like 2013-2017, I mean, it's not even a comparison. Mm-mm. Not even a comparison. But that kind of gives you an idea that individual investors are actually stepping into the market and wanting to be a part of that game. Mm-hmm. And it's been a good year in the last year, obviously. Hopefully this will drive some momentum going into 2021. Well, let's flip over and take a look at the next chart. The next chart basically that we've got is going to touch on certain sectors tied to the reflation trade. What do you think,
Brandon? Yes. So we're looking at the reflation trade. Obviously, you know, these charts that we're looking at is comparing the different sectors that you really want to hold. And we've, you know, got these side of the Fidelity accounts as well during when a time when interest rates are going up. So obviously you've got your energy that's, you know, outperforming them all. They're all outperforming the general market by far, but energy is definitely leading the pack. Financials obviously is a strong second. When interest rates go up, banks make more money, so that makes sense there. So, you know, financials have got a good holding there. Communications, materials, industrials. So, you know, we've got a lot of these individual sectors that are outperforming the market, so it's really important to kind of hold these in the portfolio, and that's why they're there.
They're more volatile though than the overall benchmarks that we usually see with the S&P 500, the Dow Jones, maybe the NASDAQ. NASDAQ's been pretty volatile though. Yeah. But these definitely are more volatile, and we don't want to have a tremendous amount of concentration there, but to have them in the portfolio sure does help.
Yeah,
delivers a little alpha.
Yeah, it's helping out, and you're, like I said, it's outpaced the market, so that's exactly what you want. But yeah, they have big swings too. They can go up, you know, 15-30% in a few months, then they can go down that quick too. So that's why we don't want to expose it to a lot.
The chart itself shows energy. It's corrected about 7-8% in the last week, but still far outperforming anything else this year.
Absolutely.
What about reallocations? We got those coming up in a couple of days. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, we got reallocations coming. I mean, for right now as it stands, I don't see too many changes happening right now. We might have to, you know, just kind of tweak some fixed income type holdings based off the interest rate changes. But outside of that, I mean, we feel pretty confident about these indexes and these industries here that we've got currently. So feel pretty solid about that. But yeah, you'll see those changes coming, you know, probably the first week of April.
So we're still looking for the inflation type situation that we've been having so far this year. Kind of give you a statistic to that. The 10-year note has actually moved up from 0.9 to about 1.7. Mm-hmm. Doesn't sound like a lot, but that's an 80% move in the interest rate so far. And honestly, that's why those sectors are doing so well.
Yeah.
Because when inflation goes up, those sectors go up.
Yeah. So again, stay tuned for more updates and videos. And again, track us on social media, Facebook, YouTube channel. Obviously, take a look at our new podcast that we've got out there as well. So if you've got any questions, let us know. But Brandon Rogers and Trent Bradshaw with Mind Your Money.